Hello, this is Rob Beardsley with Lone Star Capital. Today I want to talk about the recent public market volatility and how that relates to private real estate. So, been seeing a lot of Facebook posts, mainly real estate sponsors, investors talking about how, oh, I'm really glad I'm not invested in the stock market. You know, look what's happening there. Prices are going down 20, 30%, and my real estate portfolio hasn't gone down at all. And you know, just because that your 200 unit apartment complex doesn't have a ticker symbol doesn't mean that the value hasn't changed. One thing's for sure though, the private market, especially something illiquid like real estate, you know, the prices reflect the fundamentals much more slowly. And you know, if we do experience a recession due to prolonged impact of the coronavirus, then we will definitely have a pricing discovery period where you know, real estate prices do go down, similar to the public markets. But because the public markets are liquid and they're traded every second of every day, you know, they're quick to reflect, you know, perceived future fundamentals. So, but I definitely want to say that, in my opinion, you know, our real estate portfolios, you know, mine included, is absolutely not immune to the market shocks and things that are affecting capital markets right now. There are many things that are affecting real estate, not just the potential for job losses of our tenants, but also the way the capital markets are functioning right now. We've seen an extremely volatile 10-year, and an even more and spreads are even more volatile. So if you're not familiar, you know, the cost of borrowing for real estate is reflected by an index rate, which if you're borrowing long-term financing, that would be mainly the 10-year treasury, and then also a spread or a credit spread, which would be put on top of the 10-year, your base rate for an all-in interest rate. And so spreads, because lenders are uncertain, are even more volatile than the 10-year. And the 10-year is traded by bond traders and investors, and that's volatile right now because people are, you know, potentially trading out of stocks into bonds due to a flight to safety and a risk-off mentality in the market, which is lowering bond yields. But then we saw them trade all the way up from 50 bips to over 1%. So, you know, all that's happening, and meanwhile spreads are moving in the same direction or in the opposite direction. So it's really hard to tell, and it's affecting our ability to borrow for real estate transactions. So that's really, you know, slowed down transaction activity. We've seen deals fall apart due to either equity investors or your lenders. So, you know, effects are taking place today in the real estate market, even if prices necessarily haven't changed substantially like the public markets. But if real estate prices do change, you know, it's likely to occur over the next 3 to 6 months, and, you know, better buying opportunities will be available then. You know, so while I don't believe in the immunity or recession-resistant, you know, claim about, you know, especially Class B, C multifamily, there are some benefits to owning illiquid real estate, and the benefit is the illiquidity itself, because there are high transaction costs involved with buying and selling real estate, and there's a lot of, you know, things that need to be done, investment committee approvals, lender approvals, third-party reports. There's a lot that goes into these transactions, so it's much harder to impulse buy or impulse sell, unlike the stock market. It's really easy, go on your phone, go on Robinhood, execute a trade in a second. So if you get nervous or you're watching CNBC, you freak out and want to sell some of your stock portfolio, it's very easy to do so, but it's harder to do that in illiquid real estate. And that's why you see prices, they don't just immediately plummet, because a seller has to realistically look and say, well, hey, does this make sense for me right now? And there's more clarity of thought with illiquidity. So that's something I really like about real estate, because it forces you to make better decisions. The other benefit is cash flow. Cash flow, not just cash, but cash flow is king. And that's another great aspect of owning private real estate, which is, even if valuations do go down materially, and let's say you had a property that you were hoping to sell for $20 million, but from some market collapse it's only now worth $15 million, but let's say your NOI has only marginally been affected, you know, you can hang in to that deal and continue to cash flow, and there's no reason to sell, because you're able to survive off the cash flow, and the investment's able to survive, pay its debts, you know, kick out a decent return to equity investors and wait for the market to return to normalcy or back to, you know, even you might have to wait 1 year, 2 year, 5 years to wait to get back to a nice market high. But eventually you'll be rewarded for having the patience to hang in there and wait until valuations become more favorable. And you wouldn't be able to have that patience and resolve without the cash flow. So that's why cash flow is king, and coupled with illiquidity really make it for a better opportunity to realize a more positive outcome rather than trying to buy and sell in and out of market cycles. You know, the goal, as everybody knows, is to buy low and sell high. But human psychology leads us to buy high and sell low. We get excited when prices are moving up, we get in, and then prices become depressed, we get upset, and we sell out. So to combat our broken human psychology, you know, rather than trying to work with it, just remove human psychology out of it with the illiquidity nature. So yeah, so those are my thoughts about the current market volatility. I'm currently in Texarkana, Texas, practicing some social distancing, and I hope you stay safe.